Hello everyone, this is Ogar Plinkleton, and in today's video, we're going to be looking at analog devices, going old school, as they say. So a simple definition, actually a broad and general definition of an analog device, is a device that generally takes a non-electrical physical phenomenon and turns it into an analogous voltage signal. So the example I'm going to use today for this demonstration is a simple crystal microphone, which looks like this. So if a person speaks into this microphone, here's my person, they're going, ah. Their vocal cords, by vibrating, cause air to vibrate, and we know those as sound pressure waves. So in this instance, if we plot those waves, let's just say it's a simple sine wave, although it's much more complex than that. But for this demonstration, perhaps the person is going, oh, who knows? Anyway, so a time representation, we have our sound pressure waves, pressure on the vertical axis and time on the horizontal axis. Okay, so here's our microphone. And what I've done is drawn a giant sketch of what that looks like inside. What is inside this microphone? It's called a crystal microphone because this yellow thing is a what is known as a piezo crystal. And piezo crystals, when they deflect, they actually produce an electrical signal. So here's the front of our thing. Here comes the sound waves. This is a diaphragm, this red thing. And as the sound waves hit the diaphragm, it's going back and forth, causing our piezo crystal to go back and forth, which produces an electrical signal that's analogous to this. And so here's another plot. Our voltage is on the vertical axis, and again, time. And now we have voltage changing as a function of time that represents the sound pressure waves. And that electrical signal is coming out of the wire. Okay, let's take this one step further. Here's our person creating sound waves that are hitting our microphone, which is creating a voltage. Well, if we take the output of this voltage, and say we do that, and then the voltage is traveling through these wires, and the wire is wrapped around an iron core. This is made of iron. Well, that produces a magnetic field right here. So we have this analogous voltage signal creating an analogous magnetic field. And then what we can do with that, if we pass magnetic recording tape across this gap, that will become magnetized in accordance with this changing magnetic field. So now we have magnetized recording tape. Okay, so we have our magnetic tape. And as I said, if we run that over the magnetic field, the tape becomes magnetized. Then, here's another beautiful thing. If we rewind this and then do this, the tape is magnetized. So the changing magnetic field also creates an electric signal, an analogous electric signal to what was magnetized on the tape, which came from our microphone. And that produces, as I said, another voltage signal, which goes to an amplifier. And if we take that amplifier and attach it to a speaker, our comes out. And that is a tape recorder, which is an analogous device. And it all starts with a microphone, that turns the sound pressure into a voltage signal. The voltage signal then fed in through a wire, creating magnetic field, which produces an analogous magnetic field to that voltage signal. That magnetic field magnetizes the tape, analogous to this. And then, if we switch it all around, rewind it, and then play the magnetic tape, the magnetic field of the tape is transferred here, which creates another analogous voltage signal in here, fed to the amplifier, to the speaker, and what we initially recorded comes out. And today I have some special guests. My first guest is one of my granddaughters. It's Ilo Plinkleton. Hi, hello. Ilo. I think this is your desk right here.
Yep. Hello, I'm Ilo Plinkleton.
And what are you going to be doing today, Ilo?
We're going to be using these, the tape recorders.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Do you know how to make it work?
Yep.
Are you going to record something?
Yeah.
Okay.
Hello, my name is Ilo Plinkleton, and this is an analog device.
At the beginning of this video, I gave you a general definition of what an analog device is. I said generally, analog devices take a non-electrical physical event or physical phenomenon and turn it into an analogous voltage signal. Well, that's generally speaking, because as you saw with the tape recorder, we could also turn the physical phenomenon into a magnetic field. So, not all analog devices are electrical, too. And a good example of a non-electrical analog device would be a typewriter. A typewriter, you put the paper in, you strike a key, and that key moves a metal slug with the impression of a certain letter on it. And that letter, that slug, hits an inked ribbon, and that inked ribbon leaves an impression of whatever was on that slug, whatever letter was on that slug. And so that is that impression on the paper is an analog to the slug that struck it.
You have the typewriter?
Yep, I just got it.
This is another analog device.
What
it's
are you gonna...
a typewriter.
Wow. And how does it work? You're going to make a carbon copy?
Yep.
Okay, what are these papers over here?
They're carbon paper.
Can you show us?
Mm-hmm. So, you put the carbon paper like this. And you put it in between two pieces of paper. And then, you put it. They just tighten them.
What is that? It's an analog copy.
Yep.
All right. Hey, everybody, it's my other granddaughter, Eddie Plinkleton. Hey, Eddie, how you doing? Are you going to also type?
Okay.
This is an analog device. Did you know that?
Yup.
All right.
I heard you talking about it.
Okay. So you know how to put the paper in?
Hey, Edit. Like, it's gotten to the end.
The next analog device we want to talk about is a record player. And a record player is used to interpret the sound information contained on a vinyl record so we can listen to what that information is. Now, a record consists of a groove, a single groove that keeps going around and around and getting closer and closer to the center. And when you reach the end, that's the end of whatever information is contained on there. So let's talk about that. Again, I'm going to go back to the beginning here. We'll talk about the sound pressure waves produced by your vocal cords. And here is the representation of that. The pressure of the sound or the wave as a sine function versus time. In other words, the pressure is getting higher and lower, higher and lower, higher and lower. All right, I'm not going to talk about the manufacturing process of the record, but be assured that's also an analogous process. So here's our record, and as I said, the record is one groove that contains all of the sound information that we want to hear. And so the impressions on these grooves are analogous to our original sound wave. So this is a picture that was taken by an electron microscope of a needle. This is the record needle of the record player moving in the groove. This picture was taken by an electron microscope, and what it is, it's a picture of the needle of a record player. That's the needle. This is the cartridge that it's contained in. And this are the grooves, or right here. And as our record rotates, the groove is moving past the needle. And the needle is actually vibrating according to these valleys and peaks on each side of the groove. That causes the needle to vibrate. And let me show you a rendering I did of this to make it a little bit clearer. This is the model I created in SolidWorks of the grooves and the needle. And the gold is the needle, and here are, I'm representing three different grooves here. And let's see, so you can get oriented. You can see the grooves and the needle sitting down there. So as the record is spinning, the needle is moving in that groove. And you can see the sound information on each side of the groove. And that is analogous to the sound pressure waves. So as the record is spinning, it's moving, and it's moving past the needle. Well, the needle is so sensitive that it actually vibrates when it hits these bumps or the sound information. And that's how this information is transferred into that needle. Okay, so here's our needle. And as the groove is moving, it vibrates back and forth, and it's connected to a piezo crystal. And the piezo crystal is bent or deflected, and when that's deflected, piezo crystals produce a voltage signal. And then that voltage signal is fed to the amplifier of the record player, and then the music comes out. Analogous all the way back to our original sound pressure.
Hello, everybody. This is another analog device. It's a record player. So, you take this, you gently pull it, and then you play the songs. When you take it out, it starts playing.
Can you start it at the beginning? Thank you, Ilo. As you know, this is Ilo Plinkleton, this is Edit Plinkleton, and we've just finished a video about analog devices. And I think I heard, did you say you loved analog devices?
Yeah, they're so cool!
Well, how about you?
I like them.
All right. Well, that is it for this video, and I want to thank my two lovely grandchildren, Ilo Plinkleton and Edit Plinkleton, and we'll see you next time. Bye.
Bye. Don't forget to like and subscribe.